This study does not need a great deal of commentary. In the days we currently live, society has degraded greatly and people are told they can be anything they want. Sin is rampant. The aim of this study is not to single out the LGBT community, because none of us are without sin, we have all fallen short of the glory of God. But this topic is covered in the scriptures and we need to help those caught up in this sin, to show them with love, that it's not acceptable to God and it's not who they are. Homosexuality and the whole LGBT community are partaking in actions that the Bible tells us are grievous sins, and anyone who speaks about it being wrong, is labeled a bigot, prejudiced and homophobic. It is love that makes us share the warnings of the Bible. There are even Christians who think it's acceptable to practice LGBT lifestyles. Isaiah warned against endorsing sin as positive, whilst slamming the righteous. Isaiah 5:20, quote, "Woe to those who call evil good and good evil, who change darkness into light and light into darkness, who change bitter into sweet and sweet into bitter." End quote. There are sadly also Christians who tolerate a wide range of sins, and the inclusion of sinners in the church, that take this same attitude towards righteousness. 2 Timothy 3:5, quote, "This know also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away." End quote. But we must remember this too. Matthew 5:10, quote, "Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." End quote. It's very clear from the Bible, that God never changes, see Isaiah 48, Hebrews 13:8, Malachi 3:6, James 1:17, and Psalm 102:25 to 27, and Jesus and the Father are one. See 1 John 5:7, John 17:11, and John 14:9. This means that Jesus agrees in all matters with the Father. So let's look at what God said from the beginning about how human relationships must work. Genesis 2:24, quote, "Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." End quote. This is naturally repeated in the New Testament scriptures. God is telling us that a man is meant for a woman and a woman for a man, and only in the consecrated union of marriage. Mark 10, 7-8, quote, "For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh, so then they are no more twain, but one flesh." End quote. Matthew 19, 4-6, quote, "And he answered and said unto them, Have ye not read, that he which made them at the beginning made them male and female, and said, For this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh? Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder." End quote. By default, this also means that marriage is only for a man and a woman, not for two people of the same gender. God does not recognize such unions, they are not marriages in God's eyes and under His law. They are a human contract that is an abomination to God. And if any church conducts same-sex marriages, they are by default profaning God's house and acting against scriptures. Such a ceremony is void as a marriage in God's eyes. Churches must stop compromising. The Bible is truth and we cannot call ourselves Christians and defy Almighty God. We are told to come out of the world and be separate, see 2 Corinthians 6:17, not to fit in with the world. Both Old and New Testament have the same warnings about homosexuality. Leviticus 18:22, quote, "Thou shalt not lie with mankind, as with womankind, it is abomination." End quote. Leviticus 20:13, quote, "If a man also lie with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination, they shall surely be put to death, their blood shall be upon them. End quote. Genesis 13:13, quote, but the men of Sodom were wicked and sinners before the Lord exceedingly. End quote. Genesis 18:20, quote, and the Lord said, because the cry of Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very grievous. End quote. Genesis 19:1 8, quote, and there came two angels to Sodom at even, and Lot sat in the gate of Sodom, and Lot seeing them rose up to meet them, and he bowed himself with his face toward the ground, and he said, behold now, my lords, turn in, I pray you, into your servant's house, and tarry all night, and wash your feet, and ye shall rise up early, and go on your ways. And they said, nay, but we will abide in the street all night. And he pressed upon them greatly, and they turned in unto him, and entered into his house, and he made them a feast, and did bake unleavened bread, and they did eat. But before they lay down, the men of the city, even the men of Sodom, compassed the house round, both old and young, all the people from every quarter, and they called unto Lot, and said unto him, where are the men which came into thee this night? Bring them out unto us, that we may know them. And Lot went out at the door unto them, and shut the door after him, and said, I pray you, brethren, do not so wickedly. Behold now, I have two daughters which have not known man, let me, I pray you, bring them out unto you, and do ye to them as is good in your eyes, only unto these men do nothing, for therefore came they under the shadow of my roof. End quote. He was so desperate to protect the angels, that he even offered his daughters, most likely in the sure knowledge that the men didn't want them, because they were homosexuals. Sodom and Gomorrah were destroyed because of homosexuality and other iniquity. 1 Kings 14:24, quote, and there were also Sodomites in the land, and they did according to all the abominations of the nations which the Lord cast out before the children of Israel. End quote. In the time of King Isa, the Bible says, 1 Kings 15:12, quote, and he took away the Sodomites out of the land, and removed all the idols that his fathers had made. End quote. King Jehoshaphat did the same, both kings were acting under the will of the Lord. 1 Kings 22:46, quote, and the remnant of the Sodomites, which remained in the days of his father Isa, he took out of the land. End quote. King Josiah had the same will towards these sinners, having made a covenant before the Lord, to walk after the Lord, and to keep his commandments and his testimonies and his statutes with all their heart and all their soul, see 2 Kings 23:3, and he cleansed the land of sin. 2 Kings 23:7, quote, and he brake down the houses of the Sodomites, that were by the house of the Lord, where the women wove hangings for the grove. End quote. Nothing has changed by the time we get to the New Testament. Apostle Paul makes it clear that homosexuality is still a sin to God, and Jesus came to call everyone to repentance. 1 Corinthians 6:9, quote, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind. End quote. Romans 1, 26-27, quote, for this cause God gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature, and likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error which was meet. End quote. The recompense of their error they received in themselves, was sexually transmitted diseases, this is spelled out in other Bible translations. So what causes homosexuality? Like any other sin, it's caused by the devil and his demons. People give in to temptations, through ideas and feelings put into their minds by demons. But it goes deeper than that. Demons convince professionals to state that there is a scientific basis for homosexuality. Please see this 8-minute long video, in which a manifesting demon's arrogance makes it confess all this.
Mission will be accomplished, huh? What mission is that? What mission is that?
to take as many souls as we can to hell.
And what is that going to do for you? What's that going to do?
We had the satisfaction of seeing them burn in hell because they are made from God.
Well, you're going to be burning in hell right along with them. Right?
Things fast. We need to take it over. We need to get people in hell.
How do you get people in hell, demon?
It's easy. We deceive them.
How do you deceive them, demon?
With many ways.
Speak it!
Many ways!
Speak it! In the name of Jesus Christ, speak it.
We work in their mind. Their feelings. They trust their feelings. And that's what we desire, because we want them to think about things on earth and not things in the heavens. And we distract them, and we distract them, and we distract them, and they come down to us when they die.
You make them trust in their feelings how? How? Give me an example. Give me an example.
Oh, you start to trust money. They see something that is desirous, and you want it. They want it. They want their feelings, and then you say, get it. It's all yours. You gotta run. You gotta conquer it. You gotta get it. Gotta get it. And then they listen to us. These people listen to us. We deceive many. It's easy to deceive the humans that are not of Christ. We just use them. We go inside them. We talk to them. We tell them what they should do. And they listen because they are not of the Almighty God.
What about homosexuality? How does that work? Describe it.
Who are demons? We deceive them. We put a feeling. Feelings!
They have feelings.
Describe it.
We come inside of them and we say, ooh, look at him. Look at her. Same sex. And we say, look, desire them. It's inside of you. You have been created like that. They listen to us. That's what they do. They listen to us. We love it. And we keep feeding them. We tell them. And we tell them, it is in your body. You were born like this. Believe the lie. And we're so happy. Because we know when their time is up, they come down to us. And they burn.
So are you telling me, demon, that nobody is born homosexual? Is that what you're telling me? Sit up here.
Of course they're not.
Tell me now.
They are not born homosexual.
But they think they are. Why? Because what you do to them? And what do you do to them? Speak it!
We lie to them.
And you give them desires that are not of God, is that right?
Yes, that is correct.
And are they your desires?
Yes.
But they're not their desires?
We influence them. We go inside of them.
Do you use... Do you use medical science?
Oh, yes, we use...
To explain things away?
Yes, of course. We use the doctors. We use all of them. They are just a little puppy.
A string.
You've done a string. Listen. Hey, it's good. They make me ill. We enjoy it. Because the people eat lime and come to us.
What about people that experience anxiety and depression? Huh?
What about them?
Is that you? Is it demons that do that?
Yes, of course it is.
Now, I have another question for you. How do you feel, how do demons feel when people say that this is medically explained? It's a part of my DNA. It's a part of my makeup. How do demons feel when they say that?
Oh, we feel joyful. We're so happy.
Let me ask you another question. Have demons influenced medical science to believe these things?
Yes.
What about psychology?
All of it. We use many. The so-called wise ones. They listen to us.
You're giving a good testimony here today. I'm actually going to use that to share with others. Oh yeah, I'm going to use it. Yep. I'm going to share this testimony. And you're going to be used in the name of Jesus Christ to disclose truth to the world, demon. To the world in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, how does that make you feel, demon? How does that make you feel?
You tricked me.
What'd you say?
Tricked me.
I tricked you? I didn't trick you at all.
Why are you asking me those questions?
Get up here in the name of Jesus. You know why I was asking those questions, demon. Now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to go down, and I want John to get back up here now, in the name of Jesus. Now, I command you, demon, I said go down, in the name of Jesus Christ. Go down. John. You there?
Me.
Okay.
Me.
All right. So, how do you feel?
Drained.
Did you hear any of that?
Yes.
Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use this video, but people are going to see that that was not you. Okay?
All right.
And I want them to see, you know, the reality of what these demons do and how they invade people's lives.
All right.
All right?
Okay.
So I'm going to bring you back up in a second. Right now, demon, get back up here in the name of Jesus. Right now. By the Holy Ghost, I command you, Spirit, to get up here in the name of Jesus. Get up here, demon, now. Get up here, demon, now. Get up here in the name of Jesus. Welcome back. Now, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to come out of this vessel.
So please know, if you are struggling with homosexual feelings, that you can be delivered. Jesus can set you free. There are testimonies of ex-homosexuals on YouTube. The Bible also speaks against cross-dressing, or transvestitism. Deuteronomy 22:5, quote, "The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man, neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God." End quote. 1 Corinthians 6:9, quote, "Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind," end quote. Whilst in biblical times they did make men into eunuchs, there was no surgery to mutilate someone's body in an attempt to look like a member of the opposite sex, known as transsexualism or transgenderism, and there are a couple of scriptures covering those with such mutilated bodies. Deuteronomy 23:1, quote, "No one whose testicles are crushed or whose male organ is cut off shall enter the assembly of the Lord." End quote. 1 Corinthians 6:9, quote, "Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind." End quote. And if you count yourself as a Christian and have had surgery to look like the opposite gender, or are practicing homosexuality or cross-dressing, remember this. 1 Corinthians 6:19-20, quote, "What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? For ye are bought with a price, Therefore glorify God in your body, and in your spirit, which are God's. End quote. Consider, that if the Lord finds it an abomination for a man or woman to dress in the opposite gender's clothing, how much more of an abomination will he find it if they change their bodies to look like the opposite gender? God doesn't make mistakes, we were all born the gender we are supposed to be. The Holy Spirit will eventually leave any believing sinner that refuses to repent. The good news is, someone that has committed any of these sins, can repent and turn to Jesus to have their sins forgiven and be saved. If someone has had their body mutilated by trying to be the opposite gender, only further surgery to try to regain some semblance of a gender-appropriate appearance, could help give them an appearance back in line with their actual gender. Whether they go that route, is between them, and God. They would have to repent, however, of living the life of the opposite gender. If God knows someone's repentance is genuine and continues and they turn from their desire to be something God did not create them to be, they can be saved the same as anyone else. Homosexuality and the other sins under the LGBT umbrella are all forgivable, and none of us are here to judge. Only to speak the truth of God's word and help people to salvation, and we must warn in love. I hope these scriptures help anyone with any doubt or confusion, or even denial, about what the Bible says about these practices. God bless you all. Amen.